Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. If you are new here, thank you so much for tuning in. I'm Intentional Favor. Currently, I am an international student running my master's program in social work at the University of Chester here in the United Kingdom. And on this channel, I share my life experiences on issues pertaining to faith, lifestyle, social work, studying abroad. I also do a little bit of vlogging. So please, if you'd like to join this family, go ahead and hit the red subscribe button. Also hit notification bell so that I get notified each time I upload a new video. So guys, today's video, I give a clue about what I'll be talking about in this video, in a previous video, a Q&A session. So I'm going to be addressing one question I've gotten. I think this is the most repeated question I've ever gotten, and it's becoming annoying. Not just because of that, a particular question or someone sent me something that made me more annoyed, and I feel like addressing this today. Today, I'm addressing this. Okay, so someone said, "Good morning, sis. So I contacted an agent this morning that works for my university. Okay. He said social works is highly competitive. Check. Very true. Getting the admission. Check. Very true. And that I might not be given an offer because my BSc is in agriculture. Complete, like, where is that buzzer? Whatever. What? And that I might not be given an offer because my BSc is in agriculture. Fat lie. Big fat lie. Though I'm doing an internship at teaching hospital at the moment so I can get a recommendation letter and for experience. And he said if I want to meet up, I should have started whatever." Guys, this was the height of it. I've had people ask that question maybe because they don't have any idea or they've not seen my video where I talked about this before. You know, one of the first videos I filmed on this video is the application process for social work in the UK, for masters in social work in the UK, and I talked about this. Please, you will do yourself a lot of good to see that video, okay? Yeah, make sure you do. Now, hearing this coming from an agent, I can't tell you how, because I believe that so many people might have been deceived. Now, okay, maybe there's another question I will address separately, but please mind who you listen to. I believe there are so many international students that are YouTubers now. You know, let me not go ahead of myself. I will address that because it's also a question I always get. I will address this in a separate video. Let me not go ahead of myself, and I don't want this video to be too long, okay? Now, I've said it in a previous video. Sorry I'm talking this way because I don't know. Calm down, Favor. Calm down, calm down. I'm not angry at anybody. Of course I'm not, but I'm upset. Whatever. Okay, guys. So I've said it before, and in case you have not heard of it, I'm saying it again. As far as what you are coming in to do is masters in social work, and the country you are looking at coming is the United Kingdom. It doesn't matter the course, the department, the program, whatever you call it in your country, it doesn't matter your educational background, whether science, whether arts, whether social sciences, it doesn't matter, okay? So even if what you study in the university is wiring and fencing, yes, if there is a course like that, I don't know. But if I'm just giving you an example, even if what you studied at the university for your undergraduate is wiring and fencing, yes, you went to go and learn how to do fencing, bricklayer job, if that's what you went to university and you studied in your country or wherever, and you now want to study masters in social work, because you study wiring and fencing will not stop you from getting admission into social work. No, it will not. One basic thing that you need for you to get admission into masters in social work is an experience in health and social care. Probably in a separate video, I'm going to highlight these experiences. Another promise. Sorry guys, I have so many. I have more than 20 videos I would like to publish, but I've got no time for that. So I'm just, if not, I would have been publishing like maybe twice a week or something. But even to publish once in a week is a struggle at this stage of my life. I'll give you people a life update maybe some other time. But please, I'll tell you, maybe I'll talk about it, but I give some instances on that video. Again, go and watch the video. Application process for Masters in Social Work in the UK. It's a step-by-step guide. You will appreciate that video. So what I'll be doing in this particular video now, I'm going to be calling some of my friends that we're in the university together with, and I'm going to be asking them what they studied in their undergraduate study, okay? So that I just want to prove to you people now, because it seems words are not enough. Because people might think like, because what I did in undergraduate study is social work, that's why I got it. Ironio is a lie. That's not true. You know what? I've said it on this channel. Some universities denied me admission into master's in social work on the basis that I already have a degree in social work. Yes. They say you already have a degree, because Masters in Social Work in the UK especially is for people that have studied other disciplines at undergraduate level, and they now want to become social workers. So instead of you to go and tread the undergraduate route, for you to go and do a three-year program, just come and do a two-year program. What we do at master's level is what undergraduates do for 3 years, squeezed into 2 years, and that explains why Masters in Social Work in the UK is very demanding and hectic. Does that make sense to you? So none of my lecturers had their undergraduate in social work, because the first week of lecture, they told us their background, what they were doing. One was in the banking sector before she came in, and I know so many people. So guys, if you have another discipline, if you're into something else and you want to switch to social work in the UK is for you. It is meant for people like you who want to become social workers, who now want to change career and become social workers. Come and do masters regardless of what you have studied. I've talked too much. Now, the prayer I'm praying is that my friends will answer their calls. Everybody is busy, isn't it? So let's call the first person.
The mobile number you called is currently unavailable.
Wow.
Please try again later.
So it's not in your country that you hear not available. That's strange. Finally, it's ringing. Let's pray she answers. She's bad at answering calls.
Mobile number you've called is currently unavailable.
Okay, let's call the second person. This one too hasn't been answering my calls. Everybody is busy. Let's hope she answers today, because I've been accusing her that she's not answering and returning my calls. Oh gosh. What kind of friends are these? Huh?
Welcome to the EE voicemail.
Voicemail. Everyone is busy in UK. So sometimes when you call somebody and they don't answer, please don't be offended. Okay? Sometimes me too. I can be busy and maybe at work I can answer a call or something.
Welcome to the EE.
Let's hope this person picks the third person. Oh my god.
Hello?
Oh, hi, are you okay?
I'm okay, Alpha.
I'm fine. No, I've just been calling everybody. I'm filming a video. So I've called the other two people. They didn't answer. I was praying that you will answer. Okay, so I want to ask you a question, because I've been getting so many questions from people, even though I've said it several times. Even agencies are telling people that because they studied a particular course, they cannot come for masters in social work, or they won't be accepted because of that. So I've just said, let me ask my friends and ask them their background, like what they studied at undergraduate level before coming in for masters. So are you happy to answer that question? What did you do at undergraduate level?
Okay, no, my undergraduate was my first degree was in microbiology. Then I have a master's degree in public health for coming to study social work. So
good.
Social work is like a multidisciplinary program.
Yeah.
So I don't think people are restricted as long as you have the necessary skills, you are passionate about helping people,
yeah,
and you are able to undergo, I think, the 500 days or 500 hours
of experience.
Work in social care, I think you should be good.
Yeah, exactly. So basically, it's just that experience that is the major thing that you need to have, and the passion.
Exactly. Yeah, the passion and the experience, that thing will fall in place once you're on the program.
Exactly. You see, so you did science, pure science, microbiology, and even have done a master's in public health. And if I can ask, do you think your master's in public health was, because somebody might be saying that is the public health, do you think your master's in public health was what made you to get the admission? Do you think without that, do you think you would?
No, I think it's the experience that really matters.
Exactly.
The experience and the fact that you have a fourth degree, I think a good result in your fourth degree, you say 212 or thereabout, 12. Then 500 hours work in health and social care.
Yeah.
Yeah, that, I think that's the major criteria. Every other thing, even if you have done accounting, we have someone that's journalism, we have someone publication, we have someone people from different backgrounds.
Yeah.
And actually, in social care, everyone can. All you need is that passion, because it's a multidisciplinary program.
Yeah.
People from different aspects of social work. So,
exactly.
There must be a misconception, and maybe people are misleading because they don't really know. You know, some agents might be ignorant of it, and might not be like they are actually misleading. They might be ignorant. They might not know.
Yeah. That's true. I agree with you. So thank you very much for answering my call. All right. Take care.
I wish everyone the best. Everyone trying.
Thank you.
I wish them the best in their endeavor.
Thank you. Right. Yeah, later. Bye.
Bye.
Bye. So guys, she's a fellow international student and she's from my country. Okay. Some ladies are not speaking. I have one more lady to call. Let me call her and see if she answers. Then I'll call the man. My friends, they are bad at answering their phones. Oh, gosh.
Sorry, this person can't answer at the moment.
Voicemail again. Okay, let me call the guys. Even the guys, I'm not even sure of one. Let me call the one I'm not sure of first and take him off. But hopefully, they will call back. Oh, someone is calling back. Interesting. Hi, Janina. Hi, are you okay?
Yeah, you?
Yeah, I'm good. Actually, I'm filming a video. My YouTube video, and I just want to ask you a question. The video is on, so many people are having doubts about coming in to study social work at master's level in the UK. So I just want to ask people, my friends, to just share their background, so maybe when they hear what someone else studied in the past, it can encourage them to say, regardless of what you've studied, you can come. So tell us, what did you study at undergraduate level before coming into social work?
I studied health studies in Wolverhampton University.
Okay. Health studies, right?
Yes, health studies.
Exactly. So you purely did science, obviously.
Yeah.
Yeah, and social work has nothing to do with science, yet you were able to cross over.
Yeah, exactly. And I really enjoy it, especially because with the health studies, it's more research, and I wanted to try and help people, not just gather evidence.
Yeah.
So I felt like doing social really helped me with what I wanted to do anyway, and I'm happy that I was able to do that.
Oh, that's fine. Thank you so much for sharing.
It's okay. Sorry about myself.
Yeah, no worries. My regards to them.
You say bye.
Bye. Let me call the guys now. I was about calling one before she called back. This is one of the men in my class. We have two men. So even though he's asking, maybe you think it's just females that can study social work. No, we have men. I hope he answers. Voicemail. Oh my gosh. What is this all about? Is this a bad day to film this video, guys? Oh, somebody is calling back. Oh dear. Madam.
Hello?
Hi.
Yeah, how can I get you, ma'am?
Adi mama, you're on camera.
Oh, what? That's not a camera.
I'm recording, like, I'm filming a video now, so I was just calling you to share your experience. So,
hey,
yeah, so, like, huh?
Time.
Really? Just a quick question. It's a quick question. I'm just asking to know, because some people are having doubts about coming to do masters in social work. So just want to ask you, what was your undergraduate study in? And do you think that somebody might not be able to come into social work because the person read a particular course at undergraduate level?
I don't think so. No. Your undergraduate doesn't even include what. The most important thing is your experience, and because I did, I did microbiology, so
yeah,
it doesn't even affect it. But your first, your first degree doesn't even apply, for you to do masters here.
Yeah, all they need is your experience in health and social care.
Your experience in health and social care, yeah.
Yeah, exactly. So I'm just wanting to let people hear from other people and hear what other people have, what other people studied, and yet they gained admission to study masters in social work. Yeah, that's just what I'm doing.
I know my background is quite noisy, but it doesn't matter.
Okay.
Any course, but rather you can just defend yourself and answer most of the questions during the interview.
Yeah, that's fine. So thank you very much, Chichi. I'll leave you. I'll call you some other time. No worries. That's fine. You hear that? Experience. Okay, let me call another guy in my class. Let's see if he answers. Ringing. You'll be wondering why I'm calling.
Hello.
Hi, Mr. Leonard. You okay?
Yeah, I'm good.
Today
you remembered me.
Yes, because I'm filming a YouTube video. That's why I remembered you.
What
did you see? I'm filming a YouTube video, so you're actually on camera being recorded. I want to ask you a question. That's why I remembered you, actually. But I saw you 2 days ago, or was it 3 days ago in uni?
but you see that was uni.
So like I said, you are on camera, yeah. So I just want to ask you a question. I'm filming a video just to let people know that because people have been asking, I have this undergraduate degree in this, in that, in this, in that. So would that prevent me from coming to study social work at master's level? So I want to ask, what was your undergraduate study in? And do you think that's what somebody studied at undergraduate level can prevent the person from being offered admission to study social work at master's level?
I think, with social work, What I noted is not so much about what you did in your undergraduate.
Yeah.
It's what they mostly look at is how involved have you been in community service?
Yes.
What have you done in social services?
Yes.
You know, that's what they look at. But for me, I was in education. My first degree was in special needs education.
Yeah.
But special education, and I was a teacher. I used to teach in Kenya. I used to teach in primary schools. I taught in special schools. I was a college tutor as well.
Okay.
I was at some point I was training teachers in a teacher training college.
Okay.
Yeah. So and then after that, of course. I came over. This was not my first master's. This is not my first master's. I've done another master's here in the UK at Birmingham University in inclusion and special educational needs as well.
Still special education, not anything related to social work.
No, not anything related to social work. But then, as you can see, we cannot say that it's not related because, you know, working in education, it's it's social services. Really.
Yeah, it is.
Being a teacher because you're working with families, you're working with children.
Yeah.
And for me, I've been working with children with disabilities in schools.
Yeah.
And now, as a social worker, right now in my second placement, I'm working with the children with disabilities team.
Yeah.
So you can see I'm following the same line that I've been.
So what about Alison? Go ahead. She studied what?
She was a banker.
A banker?
She was a banker. And now you can see she is doing a master's in social
work. Social work, And I think one of our lecturers too was a banker. One of them, either Nicole or
So basically, it doesn't matter what you've done, so long as you have that
passion,
that passion for working and serving people and solving people's problems and all that, then you get it.
Exactly. Yeah.
So I don't think anything should stop anyone from applying just because of your undergraduate. You think possibly it doesn't match. It doesn't really matter. As long as you can prove that you have an interest, you have passion, that's what they are looking for.
Exactly. Okay. Thank you very much, Mr. Leonard. We'll settle our issues some other time, off camera.
Okay. All right. You're welcome.
All right. Yeah. Take care now.
Okay. All right. Bye.
Yeah. Bye.
Bye.
Oh, my God. Very funny, man. So, did you hear that? He was a teacher back in his country before he came over to the UK. And what was his undergraduate? Special education. And he also did a master's in special education still. But he found a way around it to come into social work. It doesn't matter. I'm not sure. Others are not calling me back, really. So, one more last person I'll call. Hopefully, she answers. Hello?
Yes.
You okay?
Yes, I'm fine. How are you?
Yeah, I'm good. So, Zilia, I'm actually on camera. I'm not sure if you're aware, I'm a YouTuber. So, I'm filming a video now. Because people have been asking me, I study this particular course, I want to come in to study social work. Is it possible? Will I be taken? Despite not having a background in social work, I didn't study social work at undergraduate level. So I've been calling people, asking them, people that are currently in UK studying masters in social work, just asking them, what did you study at undergraduate level? So do you mind sharing that? You are on speaker.
I was a banker. I used to work in a bank.
Okay. Yeah, so you are a banker. Yeah, and your first degree?
My first degree was linguistics.
Was linguistics?
Yes, my first degree was linguistics.
Linguistics. Okay, so you did linguistics and you are a banker for so many years before coming to do masters in social work. Yet we are given the admission, right?
Yes.
Yeah. Very good. Yeah. Thank you very much.
Okay.
Yeah. Bye. One last person and then we will call it a day. Let's see. It's ringing. Hope she's not at work. Many students are working and studying. Crazy. It's not easy at all.
Welcome to the EE voicemail.
Oh, wrong timing to have made call. I'm not very sure about this last person I called. I'm not sure of what she studied. But there's this my friend who is a Ghanaian. So I'm very sure of what she studied. She studied publication. I would have loved her to say it with her mouth. And if you listen to one of the people I call, she mentioned it too. She studied publication. So guys, I want to believe that with this course I have made, Okay, and with these voices you've heard, you've been convinced that you can come and do your master's in social work regardless of your previous academic background. Have I been able to? So go ahead. This is the best course you can do. On a separate video, I'm going to talk about the job prospects, because that's another question people have been asking me. What's the job prospects? If I finish studying social work, will I get a job? Blah, 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 blah. Stay glued on this channel. I've got all of that for you, okay? Yeah, so guys, regardless of that, come on, go ahead. That is one course you can easily apply for regardless of your background. Wiring or fencing, agriculture, publication, whatever it is, science, social sciences, arts, it doesn't matter. Go ahead and apply for masters in social work in the UK, provided you have an experience in health and social care. We will address that, but before that, don't put pressure on me to film that video. Go ahead and check this video where I talked about the application process, because in that video I talked about what your experience can be, how you can gather your experience. So guys, I've come to the end of this video, so please don't forget to subscribe to my channel if you have not. Give this video a thumbs up. Go ahead, give this video a thumbs up and leave comments in the comment section. Do you still have doubts? Go ahead, let me know, and share this video with your friends. Let the world know that you can come to the UK and study social work regardless of your previous academic background, and I'll be seeing you guys in my next video. Until then guys, stay blessed, remain intentional, and take care of yourselves. Bye.